And we're going to do that while we introduce graphics. Remember that our goal is to render a web page, to make a picture that corresponds to a web page. That means we need some way to make a picture, and it may not be obvious how we'll do that in Python. It turns out that just as we used a library for regular expressions and parsing and even timing procedures, if you remember that example from before, we're going to use a library, someone else's code, to do graphics. This ability, by the way, to build on existing off-the-shelf components is one of the phenomenal advantages of computer science compared to other parts of engineering. It's very easy to copy someone else's library and build on top of it. Much harder to copy someone else's building without actually reconstructing it yourself. So there are four key functions in our graphics library that are worth knowing about. Graphics.word, you pass in a single word, and we'll draw it on the screen or on the picture we're making for you. Graphics.begin tag is a bit more complicated. You have to tell us both the type of the tag and also any arguments it might have. For example, suppose it's an anchor tag, a link in a web page. We need to know what the destination of the link is. We'll have you pass that in as a dictionary, mapping href to Google. Then after that, you could call and display a bunch of other words, and those would all be underlined or they would show up in blue or however we draw web links. Eventually, we can end the most recent tag. And there's also a way to display warnings, which is basically just for your benefit. If you're trying this out in later assignments, this gives you a way of debugging. Maybe this will show up in some bold red color or something like that so that you can't miss it. So let's imagine that we have the following web page input. Nelson Mandela was elected democratically. I'm going to show you the sequence of calls to the graphics library that we would want. Well, conceptually, the first thing we're going to do is print out the word Nelson on the screen. Then we'll want to print out the word Mandela on the screen. Then we want to tell the graphics library that, for a while, subsequent words should be bolded. So we'll begin a bold tag. This bold tag doesn't have any arguments, so I'll just pass in the empty dictionary. That didn't actually draw anything on the screen. It's just a note to begin drawing in bold. You can imagine changing out your pen for something that draws in a different color. Now we instruct our graphics library to write the word was, but it's going to be bolded. Now we write the word elected, and now we're done with things in bold. So we back out of our most recent tag. Finally, we'll add the word democratically, end the period. This depends a bit on how our lexer works, but remember that our definition for word was sort of anything that's not white space or angle brackets, so this period will be part of the same word. And then it will be the responsibility of our graphics library to do things like wrapping when we get to the end of the page, to decide what bold looks like, and then to display the image back to you. So these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 calls produce this image. That's how we're going to make our web browser. While we're here, Nelson Mandela was actually the first South African president in a fully representative democratic election. And he went on to win the 1993 Nobel Peace Prize, plus a host of other honors.